Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're going to learn how to connect Excel online to Power BI. So let's get started. So this is the sample file we'll be using. This is the Power BI we'll be using for this demo. So first you go to transform data and go to data source settings. This is just for me to show you the data source first. So as you can see, it's from the C drive, so it's connected straight on the laptop. And then if you go back to transform and go to transform itself, so we're on Power Query. So as you can see here as well, just to show you that it's coming from the C drive, just from the front page and from the Power Query as well. So we're just gonna go to the source. So if you see the path here, C drive and user. So yeah, so this is just what I wanted to show you. There's nothing to close and apply here. So we're going to go ahead and publish. So just publish this to the workspace so we can try refreshing this. So yeah, we'll click on publish and then select the workspace where you want it to be published, and then it's published. So let's go to the workspace in Power BI service. So this is the workspace and we go straight to the back end. So we click on that. As you can see, this didn't work. So it's saying data source setting is missing. So let's go back to schedule, refresh, and to the data set. So you see this is not highlighted. We're supposed to be able to edit it, but because it's coming straight from the C drive, we can't do that. And also the gateway is missing. We don't really need the gateway for this, but I'm just trying to show you what it looks like from this end. So we're just gonna go back to the report, and this time around we're going to, is already the source data is in OneDrive or SharePoint. So we go to open in app, which is Excel on the desktop. Then we go to file and then click on info, then click on copy path. So we're just gonna copy this path. So just copy it, just click on copy path and that's fine, it will be copied in the clipboard. Then you go back to the report and then click on transform data. This time around you go to get data. You can do this from the front page, it will still bring you back here. So go to get data and select web. So what we're trying to do is to connect to the OneDrive online instead of the Excel file on the desktop. So we'll paste what we copied from the copy part, and then we'll delete everything else from question mark web equals to one. Anything from the question mark and to the end, from that to the end, you delete it and then you click on OK. And yeah, this should be fine. So once you click on that, we're going to connect to the file, but this time around the one online. So that is loading. Once it loads, we're just going to select the sheet we're interested in, which is lab one, and then we'll click OK to just load the data. So we'll click OK, so it's loaded. So the interesting thing we're going to do here, we're not going to use this. Instead, we're just going to copy, go to the advanced editor, copy the first three lines, just stop after data and the last thing after data, comma and order, copy order. We're just going to copy that, and that's from the new one. So we go back to the old one we had that had the C drive. So we go back to that, go to advanced editor and click on that, and then copy the same thing, just copy the first three, but you're not copying it, you're just gonna select the first. If you see here it says C drive, we'll just select the first three and delete that and paste the new one there just to replace this. Exactly what we're doing is just to change the data source instead of going all through, like trying to change the field to fetch from lab two. We're just gonna change the data source and everything else will be fine. So if you see here, now it's fetching from the web, it's no longer showing C drive for lab one, which is the table we had before. So we changed it, we got the new one and just made the old one the new one. Then we're gonna go ahead and delete the lab two since we don't need it. This is me just trying to show you that this is coming from the web. So we delete this one because we don't need that anymore. And then now we can close and apply. So we can close and apply this because this is all we need. We don't need the lab to. So now this is done. We've succeeded in changing the data source. So this is loading. The next thing we do is to publish this to the workspace, the same workspace. Then it's asking us to save. So we save this and then we publish to the same workspace. But because we have an existing one, it will ask us to replace. And when that comes up, we just click on replace. So replace the old one with the new one. So you can overwrite the old one. Then we say okay. Then we'll go back to the Power BI service. We can, if you click on refresh, it will break. So we just go to schedule refresh because we need to connect the data source. So here you see this has popped up. So now we can actually work on it. We still don't need the gateway, but now it's recognizing that it's connected to cloud. So we don't really need to do much here, which is fine. The gateway, we don't need the gateway. We don't need to touch that. So we just go to edit credentials and then we connect to OATP. Sorry, Organization Authorization, OAuth, and then we select organization, and this will connect us to our SharePoint. So you say, then we click on that, and then you sign in. So you're trying to sign into your OneDrive online through Power BI service just to connect that and validate your credentials. So once that is done, it shows here that that is done. So the next thing we're going to do now is to try to schedule refresh. This is just a demo, so you can just choose maybe 5 a.m. as the time when it will refresh. You can also ask someone that you want to receive email aside from the data source owner, which is you, when it fails. So any email address you put there will get an email. So you click OK and that is done. So now we're just gonna go back and try to click on the refresh button. So why that, as you can see, this is refreshing and it's successful. So we have a very successful refresh. We can click on schedule refresh and you see this succeeded, and you see the time where that succeeded, where it was successful, and that shows that we have succeeded in refreshing the data. This is basically how you change your data source from being on your computer, like fetching, importing data from your computer, which cannot refresh in Power BI service. If you need that to be refreshed automatically, you have to put it on Power BI online or OneDrive. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you next time.